If there's one goal I have for me as a game journalist, it's for people to be able to look at an emotional, sappy game and think, whoa, that's a Luis Alamilla game if I've ever seen one. That's what Half Past Fate is, one sappy, wholesome, and admirable game about relationships that I immediately fell in love with. Taking place over the span of 8 years, Half Past Fate puts you in the shoes of 6 different paths of life. At one point, you'll be in the shoes of a corporate investor looking for the next clean energy solution. In another, you'll be a second-generation Japanese tea connoisseur. Each of these 6 characters paint a different background and story, but despite their differences, their stories slowly get entwined with another for the most wholesome game I've played this year. I found myself immediately caring for each of the playable characters thanks to how well written each of them were. They came off as authentic personalities with scenarios and reactions that felt believable. The 6-hour campaign is split into chapters that have you take on a specific character. While each of these chapters focus on the playable character, they didn't juggernaut over the side characters that felt just as fleshed out the longer I spent in that chapter. When the campaign started to connect everyone's stories together, I immediately got excited about the next chapter just to see what laid ahead for everyone. I jokingly at the time described it to my friend as Avengers Endgame, and even though I was joking, by the game's ending I had the same butterfly feelings of seeing all the Marvel characters take on Thanos. That moment was only further solidified by me eagerly wanting to tell my friends about this story the moment I rolled credits on it. At first glance, it's easy to mistake Half Past Fate as a dating simulator. I know I did. It's actually more of an adventure game with a lot of the puzzle solving of point-and-click adventure games, only now presented in a top-down RPG. Like most adventure games, these puzzles have you looking for clues and items that connect with another to progress the story. At one point, I was running late for a meeting and had to get to the front of the coffee line. This meant having to go around the line, figuring out why everyone was in line in the first place, and trying to get what they needed as fast as possible. These puzzles felt straightforward and intuitive. Find the items needed to solve the puzzle, figure out the correct sequence of actions, and solved. If I had ever been stumped by a puzzle, and I really only did once by a car mechanic one, it was usually just because I couldn't find the item I needed right away. Outside of solving puzzles, the rest of the gameplay is dictated by the exploration of these sandboxes all across town. These small worlds felt beautifully crafted, each of them piquing my curiosity, getting me to want to talk and inspect any interactive item. Humorously enough, I think the game was self-aware enough to even make a joke about it while I was trying to sneak into the back of a store in another section. Each of the 12 chapters focuses on a specific character, telling you their background. Having the story take place across the span of 8 years, it slowly connects the past with the present as the mystery of how everyone is connected is slowly revealed. The anticipation was a slow but steady build over 6 hours that kept me eagerly wanting the next chapter already. While this game felt more like an interactive narrative than a traditional video game, there is some replay value here. Throughout the campaign are little hidden collectible bunnies. These play a reoccurring role in every chapter as a bonus item and an Easter egg throughout the story. Other than that, its campaign is a linear adventure that can be completed in a day, and it truly does feel like it's meant to be played in a single sitting. I actively find myself gravitating towards these short but sweet experiences more often, with Sayonara Wild Hearts, Tetris Effect, and Florence really being my favorites. Half Past Fate is absolutely stunning, using a contrast of 2D sprites in a 3D environment. It most resembles Octopath Traveler, but without the intense use of fancy lighting. Instead, the camera is angled in an almost top-down view to give everything a bit more dimension. In combination with the shadows and the shine in the environment, it's soothing to the eye. Its art style simply felt warm and inviting, with one of the best transitions in a video game I've ever seen. Walking into buildings activates this circle wipe over the environment that is just so pleasing to look at. It's the God of War Leviathan of transitions, in the sense that I can do this over and over again and never get tired of it. It's that good. In general, I was a big fan of the animations here. Characters have subtle movements to them that don't feel overly animated, but help lend to making the world feel alive when I'm just wandering and exploring it. There are some small oddities here, like this woman's thinking face looking a bit, well, it kind of looks like that, but I digress. Available on both Nintendo Switch and PC, I didn't notice any performance issues on either platform. Gameplay ran well on both platforms, and the short story size nature of the game translated well as a handheld game. If you were interested in this solely for the handheld play, then you really can't go wrong with it. Half Past Fate has a soothing chiptune soundtrack that feels like a warm hug of music. It's charming, cute, and inviting. While all the music is repeated throughout the 12 chapters, I never really got tired of it. You can easily slap this music behind a town in an unannounced Pokemon game, and I'd easily believe it was made by Game Freak. There are some clever filters used along with the music too. For example, anytime you're inside of a store, the music changes to a filtered elevator-like track that makes it sound like it's being played through a speaker. It's a cute touch that I immediately noticed. There's also some attention to detail in the little interactions of characters, like the differences in footsteps depending on the material being stepped on. The one area that I think could use some work though is the transition between songs. In more serious moments, there'd be a sudden change in music that didn't always transition well. Sometimes the music would literally just stop and start playing the dramatic music, somewhat affecting the impact of that scene. In a month where most of us are eagerly excited to shoot demons in Doom Eternal or live out our island adventure in Animal Crossing, Half-Past Fate is a good old wholesome adventure game that feels as traditional storytelling as it gets. Sure, some more gameplay could have been nice, but sometimes a good story is all you need, and it's surely what I needed. Over the course of 6 hours, I went from knowing nothing about this game, smiling at the rom-com drama throughout it, and then eagerly waiting to see how it wraps up by the end of it. I only wish I could relive the experience or had more reasons to go back and play it again.